Erythema multiforme is an ulcerative, blistering inflammatory condition which affects either the skin or the mucous membranes, most often manifesting as a mucocutaneous lesion. Now, depending on the severity of the condition and the extent of the mucosal involvement, it can be classified as erythema multiforme minor and major. Previously, two other conditions called Stevens-Johnson syndrome and toxic epidermal necrolysis were considered to be a part of the spectrum of erythema multiforme, although on the more severe end of the disease. They involve wider areas of the mucocutaneous region and can be life-threatening. However, these two conditions are now not considered to be a part of the erythema multiforme spectrum and are designated as distinct entities. Erythema multiforme is most commonly triggered by microbes, although a small but significant number of cases are also caused by drugs. On the other hand, Stevens-Johnson syndrome and toxic epidermal necrolysis are almost always caused by drugs. Herpes virus is most commonly implicated in causing erythema multiforme, and other infectious agents implicated are Mycoplasma pneumoniae and Histoplasma capsulatum. Drugs such as sulfonamides, non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs, cephalosporins, barbiturates, and even corticosteroids have been known to cause this condition. So, erythema multiforme has been hypothesized to be an immunological disease where tissue damage is a result of the body's reaction against microbial antigens or antigens from the drug metabolites. In herpes-associated erythema multiforme, the herpes viral DNA is engulfed by macrophages and presented to the CD4 T cells, thus activating them. Also, the fragments of viral DNA antigens are deposited in the keratinocytes of the skin and the mucous membranes. Activated T cells release a cytokine called interferon gamma, a pro-inflammatory cytokine. Now, interferon gamma upregulates the production of other cytokines and chemokines. So, these other cytokines damage keratinocytes, and chemokines further recruit macrophages, CD8 T cells, also called cytotoxic T cells, and natural killer cells, all of which cause epithelial damage. Keratinocytes may also present these antigens to CD8 T cells via MHC molecules. And these CD8 T cells recognize these antigens and induce apoptotic cell death of the keratinocyte. Now, drug-induced erythema multiforme lesions, on the other hand, cause tissue damage via tumor necrosis factor alpha. So, macrophages produce tumor necrosis factor alpha, also a pro-inflammatory cytokine, implicated to be predominantly involved in tissue damage in the drug-induced form of erythema multiforme. So, erythema multiforme commonly occurs in young adults, usually within 20 to 30 years, predominantly in males. The disease may have a 3 to 7 prodromal period of fever, fatigue, and malaise before the appearance of lesions on the skin and mucous membrane. Erythema multiforme minor is the milder form of the disease and is characterized by appearance of skin lesions with involvement of only one mucosal site, predominantly oral mucous membrane. Sometimes the disease may manifest with only the oral mucosa affected. Skin lesions are characterized by the appearance of symmetric erythematous macules, papules, or sometimes even blisters predominantly on the arms and legs. A very characteristic feature of the disease is the appearance of what are called target lesions or bullseye lesions. Now, these are concentric ring-like lesions that are less than 3 cm in size and have two or more erythematous rings that are paler than the central disc they encircle. Oral lesions may start as macules or papules, which may progress to become blisters. Now, blisters may erupt or erode, causing ulcerations and bleeding in the oral cavity. The disease commonly affects the anterior oral cavity, and patients commonly present with swollen, ulcerated, bleeding, and crusted lips. The oral lesions are very painful, and patients have difficulty eating and drinking. Ulceration is usually diffuse, and other sites like the buccal mucosa, tongue, floor of the mouth, and soft palate are also commonly affected. Erythema multiforme major has similar skin and oral manifestations as the minor form of the disease, except that the lesions are more widespread and may involve two or more mucosal sites. Erythema multiforme major may additionally involve laryngeal, esophageal, genital, or ocular mucous membranes apart from the oral cavity. The histopathology of erythema multiforme is not diagnostic and may resemble other vesiculobulous lesions. Hence, diagnosis is more often based on the clinical features. There may be a subepithelial lichenoid infiltrate consisting of inflammatory cells comprising of lymphocytes, neutrophils, and monocytes. The spinous layer may be edematous and the epithelium may show necrosis in the basal as well as the suprabasal regions. Now, this may result in the formation of suprabasal as well as subepithelial bullae. Erythema multiforme is usually self-limiting and may resolve in 2 to 6 weeks. Treatment is symptomatic and supportive and may consist of oral irrigation, sufficient fluid intake along with topical anesthetics to reduce pain. If the disease is suspected to be due to herpes infection, acyclovir therapy should be initiated.